These are carpenter ants, also known as Camponotus pennsylvanicus. They have been living 3 months without food. The queen has used all of her energy stores to raise the brood and workers. Without food for any much longer, her colony will starve. The workers have found a droplet of honey. They drink it quickly to prevent any other animals from stealing their bounty. They quickly rush back to feed the workers, brood, and queen. The workers are so full you can see the honey through their abdomens. The ants quickly alert their sisters about the abundance of food. First, the ants feed each other. Ants feed each other through a process called trophallaxis. The ants will vomit out their food to feed the other workers. Day and night, the workers tend to the queen and the brood. As the workers digest the honey, you can see their metabolism become faster and they become more energized. Their movements become more sporadic and fast. The workers will now continuously go out to forage. The younger workers stay in and tend to the queen and the larvae. The older workers will bring back food to feed the colony. You can repeatedly see them going in and out of the test tube and feeding the queen, as well as the other workers. The foragers feed the colony until they are full. After 2 months, many of the larvae have matured, and there are many more workers. Here, a worker feeds on a droplet of honey. You can see the ant's tongue flicking in and out of the honey droplet, slurping up the good nutrients inside. Many workers join as the colony takes advantage of this carbohydrate source. As fall begins, the temperatures start to drop. The metabolism slows down in the ants. This is most evident in the queen. Because she is so large, the temperatures affect her the most. The ant colony will need to prepare for winter. larval development slows and will eventually come to a halt. Because the ants can't forage during winter, they will need to stock up on nutrients. The foragers start to leave the nest and continuously bring back food to feed the queen as well as the other workers. The workers have been feeding so much their abdomens have become bloated with honey. Their abdomens expand as they are being filled with the sweet golden liquid. That will be the last meal they'll have this year. The workers lick their home clean. Ants have saliva that have antibacterial components. Nesting in the soil, they are naturally home with bacteria and mold. To keep the colony safe and clean, they lick everything. The ants continuously feed one another. Looking closer, you can see the ant tongues, which they use to feed and clean. Here, an ant is licking the test tube. You can clearly see its tongue. The queen lies nearly motionless as her metabolism begins to slow to a stop. Looking at the translucent larvae, you can see the food inside of their bodies. Every yellowish, orangish dot is honey within their stomach. The workers continuously lick the larvae clean, preventing them from being prey to microbes and mold. You can see the tongue of the worker coming onto the larvae, licking it clean. The ant larvae then moves its jaws, maybe in satisfaction. As temperatures reach 0 degrees Celsius, water freezes. How do ants survive winter? The formation of ice in cells can cause cellular damage, as seen here in plant cells. With temperatures in North Dakota and Minnesota being so cold, how could the ants combat the ice forming in their cells? The answer lies in this molecule, glycerol. When winter arrives, glycerol is produced by the ants. But how does glycerol stop water from freezing? When water freezes, the hydrogen bonds of the water even out, forming a crystal lattice. Glycerol forms strong hydrogen bonds with water, competing with the hydrogen bonds between water and water, preventing the water from freezing. with glycerol and extra food, will the ant survive winter? Find out in another episode.